Hey everyone, welcome to 99.6 The Howl, episode, where are we at, 4, I'm not even going to count another episode, maybe that'll be a series on its own, but for now, for the uninitiated, this is an unedited YouTube vlog discussing everything Arizona Coyotes, still winless, still haven't won, just in case you guys forgot. And I'm your only source of information for this team. They're playing well, though. I mean, these are some of the most entertaining games I've seen them play in probably a year, more than a year. This team is 100% better than seasons past, especially last season. But just some breakdowns, you know. That's all it is. If you look right here, I don't know, you can't even explain that. Should Demers be on the penalty kill there? No. Was our team built to have him there? No. So, you know, take it with a grain of salt. Should that goalie be in net? No. Was our team designed to have that goalie in net? Definitely not. So what's going on? There's five one-goal games the Coyotes have been a part of. Every one of those games could have gone either way. They've had two blowouts, Vegas and Boston. Boston was a really bad game. Vegas, too much emotion. Franchise opener for Vegas. No, we'll give them a pass. But to be honest, I mean, if this team had their starting goalie in net, every one of these games that have passed, this team would have like 4 wins. It's just frustrating. I mean, you have 2 AHL caliber goalies rotating in and out, and you can't do much. The Cowboys are playing great offensively and okay defensively, but with that type of skill in net, you gotta be better defensively. And they get wins. They're not getting wins, but they're playing great. Tocchet, his system's working. You can see it. These players are hitting the other team with so much speed and pressure. It's honestly outstanding to see how each shift these players have so much energy and they're not tired. And even if you looked at games last year, this team looked gassed in the second period or third period, and they weren't even playing as much pressure as they are this year. But you look at Ronaldo, Kempe, Domi, Keller, Reeder, Dvorak, Marner, Kraus, even Fischer. All these guys are just running. They're actually running to the other team whenever the other team has a puck and the other team's making mistakes. And the Cowboys are capitalizing on these breaks the teams are making. Honestly, one of the weak points I've been seeing this season is lack of secondary scoring. It hurts when Perlini's injured as well. Even Richardson being injured, he was playing in goals last season. But the top line of Domi, Stepan, and Keller is just unbelievable. Keller's got 5 goals leading the league in scoring. Stepan just got 2 goals last night, his first goals as a Coyote, but he's putting up points. Max Domi is Max Domi. Every night, every game, just great to watch Domi. Duclair needs to step it up. I thought he was playing great the past couple games, but Tocchet decided to put him on the fourth line. Not as a demotion I saw, because Duclair was still on the power play, but, you know, just to get that fourth line maybe some offensive prowess. Because Ronaldo and Kempe are getting chances, and they could use a goal scorer like Duclair on their line. But I don't think Duclair is the one that should be there. I think Duclair should be on the second line with Devo and Reeder. Devo's got to step it up. He's playing great hockey. He needs to pot in some goals. He had a great play with Keller near the end of the game last night, setting up Keller for his second goal of the game. But, you know, Devo needs to step up offensively. When Perlini comes back, he's got to start scoring. Kraus, he's got to pot a couple goals in. Sure, he's great on the forecheck, so is Fisher, but we need Kraus to start, hitting the back of the net, start tickling the twine, as you will. But yeah, we got Chicago Saturday, which it's never a good thing to have Chicago come into your barn. And then they got an Eastern road trip. But honestly, if they keep playing the way they've been playing, I'm fine with it. Fine with it. Trust me, once they get Ranta in net, game over. He's played one full game, and in that game, made like 45 saves, had like a 970 save percentage. Just patience. We've been through worse stretches of hockey in the past 5 years, so at least they're playing entertaining hockey, and if they're mostly one goal games. We had two blowouts. We're hitting the post in Dallas. Stepan hit the post last night. Someone hit the post. Someone remind me. Someone hit the post. Could have gotten it. It was Keller. He had an amazing shot, and it hit the crossbar. So, game of inches. That's it for me. Thank you for watching. Tucson hasn't played since last Saturday, so I'm not gonna make a video on Tucson. Strome will probably play Saturday with the Roadrunners and get a couple of points. That's good. Keller's so good. Anyways, thank you for watching. Thank you for your support.